Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Stealwing 33 Plays Enter the Gungeon. I'm Stealwing 33, and today I think we're due to play the pilot, and we're playing with the pilot's Mad Max gear on this run. I'm very excited to get back into playing a little bit of Gungeon. I took the long weekend off. It's presently Memorial Day. No, I'm pretty stoked. Alright. Okay, cool. Alright, fantastic. Cool. So finally kicking that lady's helmet into the pit paid off. We got the blast helmet, which gives us slight explosive damage protection. So basically what happens is, the range at which explosions hurt us is now shorter, so that's kind of nice. So we'll hurt ourselves a lot less, hopefully. Let's get the face melter. I think that'll be great. No, but yeah, so I took the long weekend off. It's presently Monday, Memorial Day here in Chicago. It's Memorial Day across the United States. I don't know if it's a holiday that permeates beyond the United States, mind you. Like, I don't know, maybe Canadians do it or something. But yeah, it is currently Memorial Day. And I took the majority of the weekend off. On Friday, I got kind of sick, and I didn't want to record any videos that day. Although I think I posted something, I don't remember. But Saturday and Sunday I didn't post anything, if I'm not mistaken, because I was taking the weekend off. Normally I don't take weekends off. I just keep working. But this Memorial Day weekend it's been a tough month. Lots of work's being done on Kickstarter campaign and on this and that and the other things. So I needed like a weekend to kind of get myself together, because we've got a lot more crap going on in the upcoming weeks here for, you know, my game and all the other stuff, a lot of development stuff. I've got to be a lot meaner to my friends over time here, which I'm not looking forward to, actually. We're entering the stage of the project where I have to actually do production design rather than like doing something else in particular, which, you know, is fine because it's my job, but, you know, it just kind of sucks because up to this point, like, it was easy enough to, like, you know, be friends with all of my team members and stuff, and we are still friends, don't get me wrong, but now I have to be like, it's hard when you have to, like, make decisions and tell people, like, that they're not doing, like, doing X, Y, and Z correctly or something like that, which I haven't had to do yet, but, it's hard to do that and maintain, like, you know, a friendly environment for yourself and the people that you work with. It's one of the foibles that comes with management, which, you know, it should be fine. I'm not terribly concerned about it, mostly because my team's, you know, mature adults and they can handle me being, you know, their boss for at least the majority of it. Because as much as we are friends, they all appreciate that I want the best for the project, as much as any of them do. So anything I do is normally for the sake of the project, not for, you know, some petty reason. But, you know, that's just something that I'm stressing out about it, because it's been a little bit since I've had to, like, actually do anything like that, and I appreciate that, you know. It's not the kind of thing that my team's used to out of me, because up to this point, we've been working on it more like a hobby project, you know, like a something that we were doing and we were serious about it, but it wasn't something that, like, you know, it wasn't a job yet. Now it's a job. We got our Kickstarter funding, and as soon as the funding comes in, then this turns into a job, because now we've got money from what amounts to investing people to do it, right? So it's important to sort of remember that kind of stuff when you're making decisions and trying to guide the progress of the game forward. Bullet time is a very good item. Is it better than the Molotov? Yes, because it's defensive. The Molotov's a great item. It's super good. It continues to be good for the majority of the game. But its biggest foible is that it doesn't work on a lot of the bosses early in the game. In fact, I think it works on less bosses at the beginning of the game than bosses it works on during the course of the game. So, you know, we got that to look forward to. But bullet time works on all of them, so fuck it. And we got the bullet gun. This gun's not so great. It's better than trying to use the shotgun against a lot of the enemies, but you know, that's not saying much. They did miss a golden opportunity to make it so that this thing spells out reload when you use it, which is a shame, but you know. Bullet time's super good. You can basically use it to dodge a tricky attack. So like against the high drag gun, I'll probably end up using it to dodge like the fire breath attack, because it's a lot easier to see where the attacks are occurring from. It's a lot easier to dodge them that way. I just need to get rid of one of these assholes. Which, you know, we're getting there, but it's coming down to it a little bit here. Not by too much though. There we go. All right, let's go ahead and reload the bullet gun, which has the longest fucking cooldown, the reload speed in history, which, you know, it's pretty bad. That's why this gun's bad. It doesn't do, like, enough damage to, like, warrant the reload speed that it has, which I appreciate is not, like, not the normal case here, but it's kind of rough to try to fire this thing, and it fires in like a burst, so it's impossible to control like the shots that you're taking. But the nice part about that is that it does increase the rate of fire at that rate, which, you know, is a good thing about the gun. It does shoot very quickly. I just wish it reloaded faster. Things like grease cylinder can fix that. I think there are a couple other items that increase our reload speed, but it ended up not mattering because we ended up getting mastery on it anyway, so who cares. I'm not a doctor. That is not the right sentence to say there, but that's okay. We don't have any keys, so I'm not going to bother trying to think about, like, whether or not we're going to go to the oubliette. And instead, we will go down to the next floor, and all will be well. All will be well, hopefully. I mean, we haven't gotten guns that I think will lead to victory at this point. The Gamma Ray certainly is not a gun that I think is fantastic. It does toxic people after a little bit of, like, firing at them, but That's pretty much it. Like, that's the gun's entire claim to fame, is that it does cause a poison effect. So as soon as they're poisoned, I just stop firing at them, but it does awful damage. And if the target can't be poisoned, then, like, the gun's terrible. Or if the target has too much HP, the gun's terrible. Obviously, it's good against small enemies. Because it's a beam weapon, so you just have to kind of hold it on them for a couple seconds, and it'll do the do. Most of the time when I talk about a gun being bad, I normally mean against bosses or against, like, regular enemies, not against tiny enemies. Because there are a lot of guns that are pretty terrible that aren't super good against, or that are super duper good against, like, small enemies. For instance, the Gamma Ray is one. I don't like the Gamma Ray very much, but it's super good against these Globulon enemies. You just hold it down and then kill all the parts of them. It's also super good against these bat guys, because you just wave it around and they die. But, you know, against, like, Bulletkin, like, that's normally where, like, a gun has to be good against Bulletkin, otherwise it's garbage, in my mind. We're gonna buy the keys on this floor, because, we need keys. We need keys to succeed. Which, you know, that's a thing. Ow. Alright. Gamma Ray really not the best weapon in the game. It's better than our other options, which is why I'm using it. Well, I guess it's not better than the bullet gun per se. It is more consistent than the bullet gun, which is nice, but that doesn't necessarily mean that it's better. Consistency is something that I do prize in a weapon, like, significantly. And, like, you know, that's why the Rogue Special is, like, one of my most hated weapons in the game, because it's inconsistent. And that's inaccuracy, mostly. Like, there are guns that, like, I enjoy that are, not the best. Like, I miss having, like, the Fight Saber every run. I miss having, like, there are guns that we used to get, like, all the time that, like, we haven't gotten in a while that I do wish we got more often. The Fight Saber being, you know, high on the list. Like, we used to get that almost every run, and now we don't, which just sucks, but that's kind of whatever. Bullet, bullet, bullet. One thing I will say about the bullet gun is that I don't mind it that it says bullet constantly, all the time, forever, like a goddamn idiot. As you can hear, the sarcasm in my voice is palpable. It's palpatinable. Alright. Yeah. So one of the major issues with this gun is that because it has burst fire on it, it's impossible to control the amount of bullets you're firing at somebody at any time. So, like, there are times where, like, I'll fire and, like, waste 6 or 7 bullets on the target because the target dies halfway through. But, like, with a shotgun, like, I could control how many bullets I'm firing at the target. Hey, charm horn. Awful, awful, awful item. We're going to leave that behind. Health in there. Fucking great. Charm horn is... it's so bad. It would be bad in comparison to, like, the Molotov. Gun got Shrine. Alright, we'll take a little bit of that. Don't mind. We do not have any weapons that are, like, particularly good with the Gun got Shrine, mind you, but... whatever, I guess. I guess it's fine. But that's alright. We'll just get by on what we got. Hopefully, you know, even getting, like, just 3 stacks of the Gun God Shrine will be totally fine in the long run here. Let's grab Gamma Ray ammo, I guess. I guess we can keep using the sawed-off. I just don't like to use the sawed-off after, like, the first 2 floors. I guess we're on floor 2, so I'm complaining about nothing here. Although, granted, using it against Elite Shotgun Kin probably wasn't the best idea. Because, you know, these guys are assholes, and they hit me when I'm using guns that I like using. Let alone trying to use, like, that fucking sawed-off against them for whatever reason. There we go. Alright. Easy peasy. I'm hoping we get a little bit of extra money, because then we'll be able to use the Gun God Shrine one more time. If we get to, like, 30... Well, I want to use the Gun God Shrine more than I want... It depends on the quality of this next chest. That'll determine what we use our money on. Because if the next chest is, like... If the next chest is green or better, maybe we'll consider not using a third stack of the Gun God Shrine. But, if it's blue or brown, we'll say fuck it and save our keys. Which, you know, would be fine. Let's go grab bullet ammo. Alright, cool. Bullet gun, lowercase r gun. You know, I wish we had some better weapons right now. We're gonna survive, obviously. We're gonna persist on the shitty number of weapons that we've gotten so far. Well, it's not a shitty number, it's shitty quality of weapons. Like, the weapons we've gotten are pretty bad. And not for nothing, like, they're just sort of bad. Like, you know, I don't like the Gamma Ray. It's not, like, a terrible weapon, but it's not good either. It is a green chest, so maybe we'll try to buy a key with any money we get off of the boss fight. But we'll see. I'm a little nervous. Amoconda. Alright. Not a boss fight that I'm excited to fight with our current setup of weapons here. Granted, you know, I can use my shotgun against Amoconda pretty effectively, which is nice. Shotty in the body. Oh my god, kill this thing already, Jesus! Woo! Oh, hot damn. Alright, just keep raying him. Gamma rays for life. Cause fuck it, why not? Ah, damn it, we got hit. This boss is just, it's too hard to dodge it sometimes. Really gotta break some of the segments on the side of its body here. Forever gonna get through this. Alrighty. There we go. Just keep firing at it. That's a good strategy. Just keep firing. Jesus, we took a lot of damage on this boss fight. I'm not happy about that. There we go. Alright. It took a minute, but we did it. Fucking hate that guy. The Raiden Coil. Or no, that's the... It's like the Tesla Arc. Thunderclap. There we go. How much money do we end up with? 33? Alright, let's go to the... Okay, the thunderclap's actually not bad. I can either get this key and open that green chest, or I can go do the gun god shrine. I guess we'll do the key, because it is green quality, and that's pretty good. Open this up. Yeah, it was the void core assault rifle. It's not a bad get, actually. Again, it's a consistent weapon. That's kind of what I like about it. So is the thunderclap, for that matter. The thunderclap's just kind of not great, like, in any way. Which, you know, isn't its fault at all, but, you know, it's just sort of, it's one of those guns that, like, I'm not upset that I got it, but I'm not, like, super particularly happy that I got it. Well, luckily we're gonna be at full health again. We didn't get mastery on Amokanda, but that's, I don't think anyone's surprised that we didn't get mastery on Amokanda. If you're surprised, allow me to direct you to almost literally every other video where I haven't gotten mastery on Amokanda at this point. Bosses, just, I can't figure them out for some reason. It's a little too much for me. That's alright. That's right. Black Powder Mines, Chamber 3. Let's do this. Still not super psyched about the quality of the weapons that we've received so far. The Thunderclap's not bad. It's a little inaccurate for my liking, but it will make very good use of our, the YV shrine, the pop pop shrine, the gun god shrine. There we go. I found the words I was looking for. And it's got an uncapped fire rate, which is nice. Like, so if you hold the button down, it has a fire rate, but you can like mash click it to make it fire faster. That's what I mean by uncapped, if you're ever wondering what it is I'm on about that. Weapons with uncapped fire rates are super good. The flash rate also has an uncapped fire rate. So the faster you click it, the faster it shoots. Oh, I thought it did. It apparently does not. But that's right. We good. We Gucci. I probably should be saving the Void Core Assault Rifle for when we fight the boss. Weapon does a lot of damage, and I think out of all of our guns, it's the easiest one to use, I guess is the best way to put that. There we go. Go ahead and just pop a table up here. Fire away at this guy. I think we're doing alright. I mean, okay, so the Thunderclap's a lot better than I thought it was. I remember it being significantly worse than this, to say the least. But I think I was mistaken. It might just be that we have the pop-pop thing on, and guns that shoot at, like, this medium pace plus the pop-pop weapon is, like, super good. If it ever worked on slower weapons, like, if you ever had the opportunity to make it happen on slower weapons, if you had, like, 4 stacks, I think that a slow weapon would be the premier way to make the pop-pop statue's effect work for you. Because at 4 stacks, you're basically having, like, a 40% chance per shot to, make the effect go off. But at like 2 or 3 stacks, your best bet's like something medium speed like this one, or something with an uncapped fire rate where you can just sort of force it to happen via statistics. Like, I just fire fast enough where it's not like a fair comparison to like base my stuff off this, because like statistically speaking, I'm firing much faster than any other weapon will fire. The same thing, it's the same principle that works with, like, a shotgun. But shotguns shoot in, like, a straight line out the top of the gun when you fire them with the pop-pop beam. Pop-pop effect. Pop-up effect. There we go. Let's go ahead and gun munch some of our stuff. Definitely the gamma ray and definitely the lowercase r, can get munched. I hate both of these guns, like, a lot. And everything else we have is serviceable. Not good, mind you, but serviceable. The Gungeon Ant is not what I had in mind there, at all. I might buy the gas mask, but we'll buy the key for right now. I don't have the money to buy the key for right now. I kind of want, like, everything in the shop, so if we get something that gives us the ability to steal from the shop at this point, I might consider it. Alright, there we go. I will just fart fire at these guys. There we go. Burn alive! Burn alive, bastard! Easy enough. There we go. go ahead and just goo gauze all over these guys for a little bit here. Then we'll just put them on fire. Put them right on fire. Easy enough. All right. That's the Gungeon Ant's kind of hard and weird to use. That's why I wasn't super excited about using it. Because, like, so the fire butt, this part, it does light people on fire, which is great. But, like, you really need to, like, hit people with the oil side of it first for it to be good. But then the fire part knocks them out of the oil part. And, like, you can use the fire part to, like, push them back into the oil. But, like, that's kind of inconsistent. And, you know, I got a boner for consistent weaponry. It's sort of my, like, it's the thing that I like. It's the kind of guns that I like are the ones that are super consistent. That's why I like the Mega Hand, and I enjoy the, you know, there are weapons that I like specifically because, like, I can rely on them to do the exact same thing every single time. And that thing that they do is pretty decent. Because basically step one is consistency, right? So, like, I don't like the flash ray because it's inaccurate. As shit. It's, like, one of the most inaccurate weapons in a game. But, like, as soon as it becomes a little bit more accurate, you know, you get something like, oh, by the way, like, be careful. If you're watching this at home, you probably already noticed that the flash ray shoots a very bright flash of light every time I fire it. And it fires fairly quickly. If you have issues with, you know, epilepsy or things like that, please be advised. You probably already noticed it and stopped watching. In which case, you know, bully to you, taking care of yourself. That's good. But, you know, it's the kind of thing that you should be aware of, and I apologize, but I get the flash ray every now and then, and this gun is a scourge on the mortal men. I just don't like it. Like, I'm using it specifically because if I don't use it now, I'm never going to be able to use it, and then, like, it'll be a wasted weapon, and I'd rather get, like, the use out of it now and save, like, my good weapons for, you know, the boss fight or for, like, the third or, like, the fourth floor or the fifth floor. Or bullet hell, for that matter, because we are going down to bullet hell this episode. Just don't forget, our current goal is to beat bullet hell. Oh, that was a bad time to itch my head. Ow! Alright, easy peasy, lemon squeezy. There we go. Easy enough. Easy enough. You know, it feels nice to... What the fuck? Are you serious right now? There you go. God damn it. That's upsetting. I'm feeling confident in the run's success. You know, there are lots of stuff. We're still pretty early, and there's lots of stuff that can still go wrong. But I am feeling pretty decent about getting through the rest of these floors without taking too much of a pounding from, you know, random horseshit. We almost got stuck in, like, a worst position ever for a second there. That shotgun kin and this mushroom man had us pinned down for a second there. But, you know, it's fine. We're fine. There we go. I'm glad that guy didn't explode into bullets, or I'd have been kicking myself for getting so close to him. I'm gonna see what the chest is on this floor, and then we'll make a decision. Avenging Angel. Yeah, alright. I'm probably gonna regret that, but, you know, if the increase is, like, if it's a 20% increase like I think it is, I fell in the pit. Trying to get away from this asshole. If it's a 20% increase like I think it is, that'll be totally worth it in the long run. Then we just gotta hope that we end up with mastery on this boss, and then we'll be back to where we were. Which hopefully I will remember to use bullet time and stuff, which will make that easier to do. If we ever get into a situation where I'm getting pinned down by bullets, that's when I gotta remember to use bullet time. Because it'll get me out of the situation. It's basically the equivalent of using a blank, except that it relies on my ability to, like, you know, view trajectory and shit. Wow, both of our chests sucked on this floor. I guess I have to open one of them. Oh, double armor. Dude, nice. I guess I... No, let's just not open either. The brown chests are worthless anyway. We'll instead buy, like, the alien sidearm or something. The blunderbuss? No, let's buy the alien sidearm. That's a super consistent weapon. You want to talk about consistency in a weapon here. the alien sidearm is ridiculously consistent. And with the damage boost from the Avenging Angel statue, it'll be even better. We are going to use the Void Core Assault Rifle, because it doesn't have to charge. And it's Cannonball Rog, huh? I just immediately used my bullet time because I'm stupid. So, you know, there's that going on, which is not nice. Alright, I'm surprised we got out of that without getting hit, so let's go hide in the cubby. The game has not figured out my trick here, so... But, you know, I'm hoping that if they do find out about this little, like, cheaty thing that I do sometimes, that it doesn't get patched out, like, at all. Like, I don't know how you would either. It's basically, I'm abusing the fact that the game uses, like, very simple trajectories to do most of their attacking. I put myself away from my safety hole, which, you know, isn't good, damn it. Well, okay, so we're not going to get mastery against Cannonball Rog because I'm an idiot. And I rolled directly into those shots because I'm stupid. And apparently very bad at this video game. Jesus, a couple of these pop-pop shots are coming out strong. I think they're missing mostly, but they are coming out. The game's trying really hard to kill me here, but like I'm just immune to bullets in that little cubbyhole. Which, you know, I'm not gonna complain about. I can't shoot the boss from in there, so it's not like, that matters. I do kind of wish that the game took it more like, you have to take red heart damage in order for, you to not get mastery on the boss. Like, I just feel like that'd be slightly more fair, because, like, it would make armor worth more. Because as it stands, armor's not, like, armor's great, and it can really come in handy if you're doing something like the High Dragon fight. Like, or if you're fighting jammed bosses or jammed enemies, it can be good. But, you know, in general, armor's not worth a terribly large amount. Just because, like, it only absorbs one bullet, and it's kind of regardless of the bullet's strength, it only absorbs one. So, like, it can be, like, a really shitty bullet, and it would still be, like, you know, kind of meh. Get out of here. The Hegemony Carbine's not a bad weapon. It's definitely a good general use weapon. It's good against bosses. It's pretty decent against, Jesus H. Christ, you see all those shots? I mean, that's kind of dope. It's good against bosses. It's pretty decent against rooms. I swear to God, it's making the Half-Life noise, like when you like select an object in Half-Life, or like perform an action in Half-Life. It's like that super hard like beeping noise that this thing makes. It's kind of, I like it. Don't get me wrong, it's one of my more favorite video game noises. But you know, I just noticed it because I thought this was supposed to be Halo inspired. So it makes sense for it to make, like, the noise, like the charging noise from Halo, all of them. I think the plasma pistol's the only gun that hasn't really changed much in all the Halo games. But that's alright. Making it, in my mind, more of a staple weapon than any of the other Halo weapons. Even more than, like, the battle rifle. The battle rifle is, like, what most people remember when they think of Halo. I'm just trying to circle around so I can hit the shaman in the face with my shots here. Where the hell is he? Stop it. There we go. Not a problem. This room's pretty easy. Oh, I can switch guns with my mouse. Look at that. It's good to know, I guess. I don't know how useful that's going to be in the long run here, but there you go. Alright. Go ahead and just do a little bit of lightning here. We'll use the rest of the thunderclap, I guess, for the remainder of as long as the thunderclap lasts, basically. Because it's actually a pretty decent weapon. I was giving it shit before, but the more I'm using it, the more I'm enjoying the thunderclap. Personally, now, you know, your mileage may vary, but I am I am coming around. It's growing on me a little bit. It doesn't do, like, terrific damage. Like, I'm not one-shotting people with it, but it does fire very quickly, which is nice. What do we have that could use ammo? Void Core Assault Rifle could. Let's give it for the Thunderclap, actually. We'll do that. I think the Thunderclap's as good as the Void Core Assault Rifle. Just because I didn't know it had uncapped fire rate. That does change my opinion of it a little bit, because weapons with uncapped fire rates are generally fairly strong. Generally. Although this weapon is much better when you have a gun like the Mega Douser in your arsenal, because then you can spray the room and then set it, like, electrify it with this. Let's get rid of the Gungeon Ant and the Flash Ray. Two other guns that I don't like very much. Granted, the Flash Ray, I probably could have kept that and given it the Sawed Off instead. But, I just don't like the Flash Ray. The unfinished gun's worse than both of those guns. I'm actually astonished that we managed to get the one gun that, like, I consider to be worse than all the other weapons in the game here. Astonished. Because there are so many other weapons in the game, and we got the unfinished gun. I shot that guy square in the dome here. Alright, let's open this up. Wax Wings is not... not fantastic. It's not bad, mind you. If we end up fighting Wallmonger, it'll make Wallmonger really easy. But it's not what I would consider a good weapon at all. I'm hoping we get a key drop, because I didn't realize our shop was locked. Probably should have checked that before using our key on that green chest. Because I would like to open up the shop in order to have access to maybe buying more keys. I realize that that's kind of counterproductive. If you have a key, why use it to buy more keys? Well, there might be two keys on the shop. Not that I would ever, in 100 years, be able to afford two keys at this point in the game. But, you know, it's worth noting that that is a thing that could happen. There we go. Dealt with a jammed bullet can real quick before he thawed out. We are going to start seeing that, because doing the Avenging Angel statue did cause us to gain a stack of curse. So we do need to be aware of... we have to be aware of the fact that we have given ourselves a slight handicap. Slight handicap. There's a key. Let's go to the shop real quick here. Teleport there. Go to the shop. We're going to the shop, again, specifically in order to buy more keys, but... I also want to see if there's anything, like, if there's, like, a Professor Goopton, or there's actually, like, a good weapon on the shop, then we don't have to worry about buying more keys. It is the Heroine, and there are no keys. So, the Heroine's 98. That means that our new mission is to get 98 money, by any means necessary. The Heroine is a ridiculous weapon. It's as good as the Mega Hand, if not better. It has a slightly longer charge time than the Mega Hand, but I believe it does more damage in general than the Mega Hand does, which, you know, is pretty decent. We're basically, if we get that, and then if we end up with the Mega Hand, we'll have the three, like, layers of, like, charge weapon, in my opinion, with the, you know, the alien sidearm being low tier, and then, you know, the Mega Hand shit being mid tier, and the Heroine being high tier, top tier, if you will, not high tier. The hell am I? Some sort of sports commentator. Hello! We got a red, or a brown, silver. Jesus Christ. What is wrong with me today? Can't speak. Or that's every day, but, you know, whatever. Every now and then I get horrendously confused. It is a product of having a semi-decent vocabulary, I guess. I don't know. It's actually just me being stupid. Like, don't let me fool you. It's got nothing to do with anything. It's just I'm an idiot sometimes. Which, you know, it's good that I can admit that to myself. Every now and then. But, you know, we'll get there. Did I kill that guy already? No, I was like, where the hell did the shaman go? Get out of here. There we go. Easy enough. Easy peasy. I hope we get another key, though, because I would like to... Oh my god, mistakes were made. Opening that red chest would have been fucking primo. It would have been a premiere event. Because we could have gotten so many good things out of that. And there's another NPC room over here. Jesus Christ, this room sucked. This floor sucked, man. I did not have good key economy on this run. Don't get me wrong, we're subsisting, because it's working out mostly, but we're not doing fantastic. The t-shirt cannon, not what I would consider a fantastic weapon. Not bad, but not fantastic. All right, easy peasy. Just gotta stay dodging. Just stay away from the shots, and we'll be fine. We have two blanks, so if we get in trouble, we can try to make some shit happen here. Oh shit. Well, I guess we're not gonna get mastery on Wallmonger at all. I guess that wouldn't have mattered anyway. I feel like an idiot. I don't know why I blanked there. I didn't need a blank there at all. Reload, reload. We're going to use this opportunity to use up the remainder of our sawed-off shotgun here, because I think this is the last area of the game where that's going to be particularly useful. The Dungeon Eagle. The Deagle's not bad. Not bad at all. Damn it. There's no keys or anything. Oh, I want the heroin so bad, though. Ugh. I would steal from the shop if I could. If I had, like, smoke bombs or any of the stuff that turns you invisible, I would 100% steal from the shop. Curse be damned. I'd take the heroin for a stack of curse. That'd be fine with me. But I guess we're going on to the next floor. That sucks. Yeah, so you can steal from the shop. There are items in the game that allow you to do that. If they turn you invisible, or they, like, stop time or something like that, you can't steal from the shop during that period of time, because the shopkeeper can't stop you from stealing from him if time is stopped or you're invisible. Invisiblessed. But, you know, that's a thing. Just gotta kill this guy, please. There we go. Couldn't get a couple of those pop-pop shots on Walmart, could we, with the fucking Raiden foil and the goddamn Void Course assault rifle, could we, game? Nah, you just had to save all of them for that bulletkin on floor 5. Because that was critical to our success. Killing that jelly cube man. Alright, just take him out. We're fine. I mean, I'm complaining, but just because I'm bitter about my own performance. And only having 3 hearts, going down into the fucking high dragon fight, and then inevitably into bullet hell is not going to be fun. Because I'm really confident in myself. I'm pretty sure I can beat the high dragon on this much HP. I am not convinced that I can beat bullet hell and the high dragon on this much HP at all. Which, you know, that's on me, but still, it's not going to be one of those things that I think. I don't think I have the skills necessary to do that quite yet. You know, with more practice and more time, maybe. If we had a better weaponry set up, I could probably manage that if, like, I pressed myself to do it. But, you know, the weapons we have aren't bad. I'm poo-pooing them, but that's because we haven't gotten, like, we got a lot of the weapons that I think are pretty decent on, like, the last floor. And we missed stuff like the heroin. We missed that red chest. Like, there are a couple of times where, like, we've missed a couple opportunities for some stuff that, like, I would have considered top tier. And that kind of sucks. It kind of stings a little to, like, know that, basically. Yeah, let's go ahead and just clear this room out. Can't do it. The alien sidearm's not one-shotting people anymore. Making it slightly worse than it used to be. I haven't used the Dungeon Eagle in a while. I don't remember how much damage it does. I know it does a lot of damage, because if it's like the Desert Eagle in real life, then it fires like very... Nope, it is not like the Desert Eagle. I remember now. This gun was borderline garbage, but it hovered around okay, because it was pretty consistent. It's a nice medium-paced weapon. Which does make it very good with the pop-pop, because it does mean that it will fire... Pop-pop rounds pretty pretty often, but, you know, whatever. It's fine. We're fine. Pushing people in the pits is the best thing for the t-shirt cannon. That's what it does, is it pushes people in the pits. This gun does not do good damage. It's not the pox cannon. Now, the pox cannon actually does, like, ridiculous damage and shit. I kind of want, like, an Enter the Gungeon t-shirt. I know they just opened up, they opened up a store with some merch in it. But I would buy, like, an Enter the Gungeon t-shirt. I really want that Bulletkin plushie doll that they have on the store. Yeah, if you haven't seen about this, they do have a Enter the Gungeon store now. It's got some merch in it. I'm not being sponsored by, you know, Hi-Rez or anything like that, but, you know, I do think that, yeah, I like the game a lot. So, you know, I'll talk it up a little bit. I don't have a problem doing that. 95 money, this green chest. Doing okay. I kind of want to save the Void Course, the Hegemony Carbine for when, for the High Dragon fight. Because it would be in my interest to have something that fast on the High Dragon fight. Especially if we're going to talk, like, we're going to talk cold turkey here, like, you know, I want to be able to use bullet time as much as possible. Something that I have been neglecting to do this entire time, basically. I forget to use my spacebar item a lot. But, you know, that's on me, but... There we go. Just push him into the fire, and then just stay away from him. Albeit temporarily, but we're still fine. We still Gucci. Oh, there's a bulletkin, like, right behind me. That was scary. You get away from me. You die. There we go. We're good. Fuck this room. The hammer rooms are always the worst. We haven't gotten hit yet, actually, on any of these rooms here. Which I find startling, to say the least. Normally I expect to get hit, like, a couple times at this point in the run here. At least on this floor. Oh, come on. I can't hit the thing. I want to push this over so I can make some fire. Burn some of these assholes alive. Oh, that's right, I forgot. This guy without the hair is immune to fire because he's a skeleton. Even though skeletons do burn the game. Yeah, they do. They have to be really hot, but they burn. Everybody dies. Some just need a little help. Alright. Easy enough. Easy enough. Boop, boop, ba-doop. Right, just let him kill himself, basically. Alright, grab this health. We're doing alright. I was a little nervous walking into this floor, but we are doing okay. Whether it is because of good play, good decision making, or what have you, I do think we are doing okay right now. Are we doing great? Probably not. I would probably not say that, but we're doing okay. We're definitely behind where I want to be, which is my fault because I gave up my health to that avenging statue bullshit. So, you know, we got that not going for us, which is, you know, not nice, but come on, hit him. Gun's so inaccurate. It should do more damage than this. The Desert Eagle in real, oh, at least like in Counter-Strike, the Desert Eagle does like a shit ton of damage. We need a key right now. I need that black chest. We missed one red chest. I need a goddamn key. And I need it yesterday. Oh, I can charge it? Oh, shit. I did not realize I could charge this. Oh, that changes everything. Yeah, fuck it. This is way better now. It's got a pretty decent charge time. Seems to do about as much damage as the alien sidearm does. At least on this floor. I mean, I'd have to test it. the only way to really know is to test it against a boss, because that's the only way to really tell, like, how much damage a weapon does. Is measuring it on the boss pools, because, like, what enemies change all the time, so, like, a bullet can on floor 3 is different than a bullet can on floor 1, but, you know, the fucking Gatling goal is always the same, that kind of thing. Hoping that the blacksmith has a key in it, because I will rage super hard if she does not. If for no other reason than I really would like to be able to get that black chest, like, immediately. That would be super nice. Alright, there we go. We got a little bit more money. I thought that was a key. I got really excited, and it wasn't a key. The boss does not have a key. It does have the Polaris. A gun that is not super good right now. The anvil's not bad. Can I, like, give you the unfinished gun? Can you, like, finish this gun for me? Can you finish this gun for me, though? Yeah. Oh, cool. That's weird. I probably should have read this, but I guess we're gonna have to skip it for now. Alright, cool. Fantastic. Well, what do I want to buy? There's no keys, so I guess we're fucked. Itchy Trigger Finger increases our fire rate. It will make a couple of our guns better. The Polaris is a very, very good weapon. But so is the Anvilin. And the Polaris needs kills to stack up. How much is this? 48. Let's buy this, and we'll buy the full heart. We're just going to be pragmatic. I want to have the Polaris. It's a fantastic weapon. But you have to kill... So the Polaris is based on Cave Story, a game that came out a while back. Fantastic video game. If you've never played it, I would suggest it. It's very bullet-heavy. Basically what the Polaris is as you kill bad guys in the game, it was as you killed bad guys, it evolved. And then if you got hit, the Polaris got worse, right? So basically what would happen would be that, like, you'd play the game, and then, you would use the Polaris, and you'd end up losing, like, you know, you'd get hit, or you'd end up killing people, but the idea was that as you leveled up the gun got better, which, you know, holds true in Gungeon. As you kill people, the gun does get better over time, which makes it a very, very good weapon. Don't get me wrong, I'm not trying to poo-poo the Polaris at all. Quite the opposite, actually. I should really, really like the weapon. I can't warrant picking it up. It's like the metronome. I can't justify picking it up. All of our guns suck so much against the boss fight. Holy crap. Suck t-shirts? Nerd? Let's get rid of all of them. I guess we'll just use the Hegemony Carbine. It's slow, but at least it'll do the do here. I don't know, man. I don't know. I never heard of no Maya. But we'll figure it out, I guess. This one's easy to dodge. A lot of these attacks are not hard to dodge. You just sort of have to, like, watch your position in relative to, like, the bullets around you. And keep in mind that, like, for this boss fight, I actually don't watch the boss at all. Which, you know, it's a thing that I do. Your mileage may vary there. But, we're not getting mastery on High Dragon. But, you know, whatever. I kind of figured that was gonna happen. Because, you know, it's not the easiest thing to do on a good run. And this is, like, a medium run. Like... We're gonna go to bullet hell, but we're probably gonna die borderline immediately. I swear to God, if I get key drops on bullet hell, I'm gonna rage. Ain't no one gonna be happy about it. Not the game, not you guys. Nobody. Alright, well, that's taken care of. I guess we're out of bullets for the Hegemony Carbine. Probably shouldn't use the sawed off at all. Unless it's maybe against these guys, because I think we can get away with it here. Right, there we go. Well, I mean, we're running out of options here. Like, I can use the deagle, I guess. Ah, nope, we're dead. Alright, that's fine. Yeah, that was a product of, you know, poor weaponry. Poor weaponry and poor decision making. I shouldn't have given up that, I shouldn't have given up that thing to, I shouldn't have given up a heart to that statue. But, that's gonna do it for this episode, so thank you all so much for watching. If you like what you saw, let me know. If you want to see more, don't forget to subscribe to keep up to date on when I post more videos. And if you really like what you saw, leave a like. It helps the channel grow, it helps me out a great deal. But of course, with that, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!